Good morning to all traders and welcome to this Thursday's Market Insights video. Today is the 17th of December. We near Christmas Day and it looks like that the Santa rally has begun as we expected. Yesterday, I think I called it. Well, we've had two positive news for the markets, for risk assets, I will say. First of all, the Fed announced to increase actually the bond buying program, to keep the bond buying program intact until at least there is a sustainable growth in the employment markets and also in the economy. And they also vouched to keep interest rates low well into 2023. The second bit of information is that now the political impasse in the US regarding the fiscal stimulus seems to be actually heading into a nice direction as well, as there is now seems to be a case where $900 billion are very close to be agreed between the Republicans and the Democrats in checks, however, but still much better to what we expected. I think it was early on Tuesday where the 908 went down to 743 or something billion. So that is a positive development, of course, for risk assets. As a result, of course, the dollar was pushed down, and it was also pushed down by very bad US retail sales as well numbers, okay? And then we've had, of course, euro rising, pound rising, and all the other currencies actually against the dollar. The question, though, we have to have in our minds is whether the pound is also supported by positive developments around Brexit, because Ursula latest actually said that there is a way forward, but... and that was taken positively, perhaps, by the markets. But she also reiterated that we are still facing issues on fisheries and the level playing field, right? But I think we're going to get something there very soon as well. Now, we are expecting jobless numbers in the US today, and we'll have numerous interest rate decisions, including the SMB, most importantly, the BOE, and then also Norway and Mexico, okay? So it's going to be a volatile day, in my opinion, while euro is heading to fresh multi-year highs. And this is what I will want to start with today. We called the 3, a 4, and a 5 last week. We said that in case we break above this level, we're not going to look at the scenario where this is an expanded running flat, okay? So I see more upside with that said, which means this is a multi-structure move to the upside. I'm expecting wave 3 to be done at the 161 extension of waves 1 and 2, right? Which means this multi-structure upside, the 5 wave in the minute, is likely to end around 122.63. Then I will be expecting a move down to around 120 or so, okay, 120.60, a double bottom down in 4 for 4, and then all the way up to 125.84, for the 100 extension of the 161, right? This is going to take us the 125.84. From here, we can start looking for further clues. The case would be that this is either indeed a Y and we're going to move all the way down, or it's going to be actually a cycle wave 1 over here, right? Which means, again, there's good chances that we're going to pull lower down, but in the longer term, that would be a bullish move, right? Now, on the dollar against the yen, we've called this move to the downside last week, right? Here's what I've been looking. Well, after this running flat over here, we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. I'm expecting wave 5 to take us down to the 102.66, okay? This is going to be the first correction down, and then we're going to get another one, not corrections or impulse, and then but part of the correction, and then we're going to get a wave B, and then we're going to get another 5-wave impulse to the downside. Okay, I'm looking at this to take us down to the 100, near the 100 level. Right now, I will be waiting, of course, in the medium term for the 101 14 over here to break, because this is the previous low. Right, so if we are in a WXY, this Y, it means that we are WX and Y, right? So Y has to go below that previous low. And that low is 101.14 in our case. So In case we break, I'll be looking the 100.50, okay? But expect a bounce around 102.66, okay? And then a continuation down. And as long as we don't see any signals on the MACD on the RSI, this means that this is going to be a continuation, okay? Last, and have a quick look on the pound. I changed here my my main scenario to the alternative scenario, okay? That's what we talked last week. We were expecting this to start moving lower, but then again, I also said that I didn't like this move, if you recall, because it looks corrective, and I was expecting for another move to the upside. Now, that makes me think this is going to be a triple zigzag, okay? And that said, this is an X, and over here, we've got wave Y, yeah? So in wave Y, we're going to get a triple zigzag, and this is going perhaps to end this move to the upside, which is wave 4, and then in the longer term, we're going to get wave 5 all the way down, right? Now, it could be a case where this wave over here, there's two scenarios here. One is ABC, yeah? We've got this like WXYZ, and then we're going to get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This would be an expanded or running flat, because we literally can go up to 138 to complete wave B of an expanded or a running flat, right? So up to 138, we're still going to remain uncertain on that end. The other scenario would be that this is indeed, this is an A, this is a B, and this is a C. So we're going to see perhaps, you know, prices start moving lower for a correction as we talk. And then this is going to be wave X, right? But most likely, as I said, my main scenario remains being this over here, that this is a Z. However, it would be also the chances of that becoming a, well, W, X, Y, X, and Z. So we're going to have an intermediate degree triple zigzag as well are high, okay? Because this is going to actually keep prices between the 126 and 137 or so, okay? So in the short term, I see more upside either way. I'm looking at the 137.41, okay? Maybe even medium term. We're gonna get there until Christmas Day. Well, it's possible and it looks quite impulsive. With that said, of course, that means that this is wave one and this is wave two. And this impulse over here is wave three, which means it's multi-structural as well. So we're going to get probably one, two, three, four, and five, and then a four, and then a five. And this will be the end of this, at least for the medium term move, 137.41. Thank you for watching, and we'll speak again tomorrow.